Hello everyone, I am Nishu, and if you remember, in my last video, I discussed about back cross, reciprocal cross, test cross, different type of crosses were discussed. I also discussed about the monohybrid cross, the experiment which was performed by Mendel on the pea plant by taking one of the trait, one of the character as an example. Now, today in my part, in my this session, I am going to discuss about the principles of Mendelism, the laws of Mendel, which was done on the basis of inheritance, principles of inheritance. Now, these laws were framed by Mendel after performing monohybrid crosses. And today, we call these principles, or we study these principles by the name law of dominance or law of segregation. Law of dominance is considered to be the first law of Mendel, and law of segregation is considered to be your second law of Mendel. So, in this part of the session of my video today, I'll be discussing about the law of dominance, and it is from the complete NCERT. I'll be taking the whole part, whole explanation from the NCERT, and this has been mentioned in your book in page number 75. Law of dominance. The complete paragraph, the complete parts which I have mentioned on the board is from your NCERT book. And line by line, all the points are very important. That is why I have taken the complete concept from the book itself, so that you can understand each and every point. Because if I talk about law of dominance or law of segregation, both the laws are very important related to your exams, related to your competitive exams. It is very, very, very important for your board purpose even. So that is why I have taken up. So let me begin with the law. That law of dominance. Hope till yet whatever I have told it is clear to you. So I am going to discuss about law of dominance. And law of dominance is considered to be the first law of Mendel. So, what is the first point? First point taken up from your book is characters are controlled by discrete unit called factors. Now, what are these factors? I hope you know now. These factors are the genes. The genes are, which was called as factor by Mendel. So, this sentence is talking about the factors, the genes. Now, which type of characters? Characters like height, flower color, position of flowers, all the different type of characters which was taken by Mendel in his experiment. So this sentence is talking about those type of characters. So those characters like your height, flower color, shape of the pod, shape of the seed, all those characters are controlled by discrete unit. Now, what is discrete unit? Discrete unit is a term which is used for the factor. Now, all those characters are controlled by a unit, and that unit is called as factor. Hope this line is clear. Because Mendel told that every character which is present in an organism is controlled by certain factors, and these factors are only responsible to carry the character from one generation to the next generation. So, this is what was finally concluded by Mendel in the law of dominance after his monohybrid cross, that characters are controlled by discrete unit called as factors. Now, what does the second sentence say? Factors occurs in pairs. You know, now what is this factor? This factor is a gene, and genes always occur in pairs. Now, you are knowing it very well. It occurs in pairs. So, if I talk about capital T and capital T for the trait height, so it is your in pair. It is homozygous, but it is in pair. If I talk about a heterozygous part, capital T, small t, then it is also a present in a pair. So, whether it is homozygous or it is heterozygous, but the characters are present in pair. So, Mendel told that your all the characters which are present, all they are present in form of a factor, those factors occurs in pair. So this was also postulated in the law of dominance by Mendel. Now third one is very important. It is to be noted. Now what is third one? The third point is, in a dissimilar pair of a factor. What do you mean by this line is very important? What is the line? A dissimilar pair of a factor. This is a similar pair of a factor. Similar pair. Both the alleles are same, capital and capital. This is a similar. If I talk about A, capital A and small a. If I talk about capital R and small r, they are dissimilar factors. They are dissimilar. Capital T, small t is dissimilar allele present here. Capital A, small a. Capital R, small r. They are dissimilar pair of factors. So what is this? I hope this is clear. What do you mean by dissimilar pair of factors? So now, in a dissimilar pair of factors, one member of the pair dominates the other, recessive. It means that here, if I take here the example, your capital T and small t. So capital T is dominant. It is dominant. And small r belongs to recessive. So what is the sentence saying? Sentence says that one member of the pair. So one member, this is one of the member and this is one of the member. There are two members in one family, in one pair. So any one of the pair dominates the other. So one of the member will be dominating the other. So what is dominant over here? Capital T is dominant. So this capital T will be dominating the recessive part. That means that your recessive small t will always follow the instructions given by the dominant T. Dominant T will lead the group and small t will follow that group. I hope this is clear to you that what does the sentence mean? In a dissimilar pair of factors, one member of the pair dominates the other recessive. It's very simple. I have drawn this over here to explain you all, and you know also this, that parent is capital T and small t, small t. When I made a cross between them, cross pollination, then in F1 generation, I obtained your heterozygous allele, heterozygous gametes was over there, which was having capital T and small t. Now this was heterozygous, but if I go to the phenotypic character, genotypically it was capital and small t, but when I go to phenotypic character, they were tall. So tall, why? Because this capital T became dominant. It was dominant over here. So, and small t was following the order of the capital T. So capital T was dominating the recessive small t, and capital T took the responsibility of the characteristic feature to be observed, to be visualized from the outside. So that is why taking the responsibility, small t became a leader and it came in front. So the plants in the F1 generation all were tall in height. So this is what this sentence means, that in a dissimilar pair of factor, one pair of the pair dominant, the other is recessive. So this small t will be following the capital T. Always capital letter will be dominating the recessive one. So hope this part is clear to you all, that what do I mean by in a dissimilar pair of factor, one member of the pair dominant, the other is recessive. This is clear now. Now, this were the three points which has been mentioned in your book in page number 75. And these three are the main points on which many multiple type of question, many assertion reason type of question, true and false. Many different types of questions can be made by these three points. And these were the three main postulates, three main points which was postulated, which was framed by Mendel in Law of Dominance. Now, in the later part of these sentences also I have taken from your NCERT book only. It is just below the sentence, this three points in your book. Now, what is this point saying? This is also very important to understand. Now, what the point is saying? The point says that this law is used to explain the expression of only one of the parental character in a monohybrid cross in F1. What does it mean? This law is used. Why is this law of dominance used? This law is used to explain the expression. To explain the expression, the character to be expressed. To explain the expression of only one of the parental character in a monohybrid cross in F1 generation. So if I take example over here, what the sentence is saying? This is a monohybrid cross. Monohybrid, taking only one character as an example, that is height. And in height, I have taken two traits, tallness and dwarfness. This is what? Now, what the sentence is saying? Sentence is saying that this law is used to explain the expression of only one of the parental character in a monohybrid cross in F1 generation. Any one of the character of a parental is expressed during the F1 generation. Is it clear? No. I'll explain it. Parent generation is having one pure tall and the other one is pure recessive dwarf. But in F1 generation, after cross-pollination, what did Mendel obtain? Mendel obtained hybrid, impure type of tall plant. Now, cross was made between recessive dwarf also. But did Mendel obtain in F1 generation recessive part? Dwarf plant? No, he did not obtain it. What did he obtain? He obtained a tall plant. So, in F1 generation, the sentence means this. That in monohybrid cross, during F1 generation, any one of the parental character is expressed. That means any one of the parental character, that means your tallness, the dominant one. Any one means the dominant. It is always will be, it will be dominant. So, our dominant character is expressed in F1 generation. And the expression of both in F2 generation. In F1 generation, only one of the character is being expressed. But in F2 generation, this tall is over here, this dwarf is over here, and this hybrid is also here. What does it mean? That in F2 generation, both the characters are expressed. But in F1 generation, only one of the parental character will be expressed. I hope this sentence is clear to you. That this law of dominance is very useful to explain the expression of only one of the parental character in a monohybrid cross in one F1 generation and the expression of both in F2 generation. So this is also expressed in F2 generation and dwarfness is also expressed in F2 generation. Now, the next point what it is saying, it says that it also explains the proportion of 3:1. I hope this is clear. This you remember very nicely. What is 3:1? Phenotypic ratio, 3 tall and 1 dwarf. So, this is what your 3:1. So, it also explains the proportion of 3:1 obtained at the F2 generation. If I come to this point again, if phenotypically, if you remember that there were 3 tall and 1 dwarf. So, this is what your 3:1 ratio is saying. That your capital T, small t was obtained in F1 generation all tall. Then in F2 generation, we obtained 3 tall and 1 dwarf. So, this is what this sentence means. that it also explains the proportion of 3:1 obtained at the F2 generation. So 3 are obtaining 3 tall and 1 dwarf. So 3 is for, it means that for tallness, and 1 is resembling the dwarfness. So 3:1 ratio is this. So in complete, we can say that this law of dominance is explaining the different types of points which Mendel concluded after his monohybrid cross. I'll repeat the points. He told that all the characters are being categorized by a certain word called as factor. Then he told that these factors always, they are present in pair. Then he told that in a dissimilar factor, one of the member of a pair will be dominating the other one, that means recessive one. Then he told that in F1 generation, only one of the character of the parent will be expressed. But in F2 generation, both the characters of the parental generation will be expressed. And the character will be expressed in F2 generation in such a way that the ratio will be obtained of the offspring in 3:1. Hope, children, this is clear to you. And I had a request from many of you to take a screenshot, so that I'll be shifting away from the board. You can take a screenshot of the board. Hope, children, this law was clear to you. And in next part, I'll be moving with the law of segregation, the second law of Mendel. This much was clear to you. Thank you.